Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel. In this video, I'll be talking about a completely free, super powerful tool that you can use right away to expand your creative storytelling. I'm talking about EbSynth. EbSynth is a free application that allows you to make wholesale changes to a video by manipulating a few still keyframes. The basic workflow is as follows. First, export your footage as an image sequence. Then, select a few frames from your image sequence to stylize. Lastly, let EbSynth take care of the rest. It will map the styled animation look from your keyframes to the rest of the footage. Let me show you how it works. Start by taking your video and making it into a PNG sequence. You can do this in HitFilm by adding your export to the queue and using the preset PNG sequence. Place this into a folder called Video. Then, manipulate one or more of the PNG images in that folder, placing those manipulated images into a new folder called Keyframes. You will want to leave them named exactly the same as they were named in the video folder. You can see that I used a free online application similar to Stable Diffusion to change this pretty young girl into an old lady. After downloading EbSynth from the link in the description below, go ahead and start it by double-clicking. Now you can simply drag and drop both the video folder and the keyframes folder into the appropriate boxes. Notice that the rest of the information is automatically filled in. There are a lot of other tools here, but for this video, I'm keeping it simple, so don't worry about those for now. If there's only one keyframe, select Synth. And if there's more than one, then select Run. This can take a little bit of time, so go take a break and get something else done while you wait. After it's complete, there's a new folder for each keyframe that contains an output PNG sequence. You can create a video clip from that using HitFilm by selecting Import PNG Sequence and then select the folder. That's the basics, so go on and play with that first. There are a lot more tools involved here that make this even more powerful. If you want to know more, I'll be making a series of tutorials on EbSynth. There's a link to that playlist here, and also in the description below. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments, and I'll be happy to answer them for you. Thanks for watching.